Good morning, dear students. I welcome you all in my class. This is basically a revision class for mock test. I am Miss Rita Yadav, your English teacher. So, without any further delay, let's begin. Today, we are going to have a revision of two lessons of English literature, The Tempest and The Painted Ceiling. The Tempest is a play written by William Shakespeare. William Shakespeare, born in 1564 and died in 1660, remains to be the greatest British playwright ever. He wrote 37 plays and 154 sonnets. His plays leaves a lasting impact on the reader's mind because of his poetry and his art of characterization. He both wrote his play and acted in them. The Tempest is a play about magic, betrayal, love, forgiveness. It is set on an island somewhere near Italy, where Prospero, the one-time Duke of Milan, and his beautiful daughter Merinda lives with a spirit called Ariel and a strange man, wild man, half human being man is there called Caliban. Dear students, this is a map of the characters. Go through it and try to understand the play more easily. This will help you, in fact. Okay, now we move to the main characters. In this play, main characters which you have to deal is, first one is Prospero, then is Merinda, daughter of Prospero, Ariel, is a spirit, then Caliban, half human, then Antonio, Prospero's brother, then Lonzo, king of Naples, Ferdinand, king of Alonso, then Gonzalo. These were the characters you need to refer. Here are the pics which you will like to have a glimpse. Then I would like to describe Prospero first, because he is a main figure in the play. He is a protagonist and a central character. He generates the plot of the play single-handedly. Prospero is the Duke of Milan, father of Merinda, master of Alien and Caliban. Now I am going to give a complete summary. A raging storm at sea threatened a ship bearing Alonso, king of Naples, and his court on their voyage home from the wedding of Alonso's daughter in Tunisia. Frustrated and afraid, the courtyards and the ship crew. From a nearby island, Prospero and the former Duke of Milan, and his daughter Merinda watch the ship. Merinda worries about the ship's passenger, suspect that her father has created the storm using his magical power, and begs him to calm the water. Prospero then reveals to Merinda the details of their past, telling how 12 years ago his brother Antonio betrayed and overthrew them. With the help of Alonso, Antonio arranged for Prospero and Merinda to be kidnapped and set adrift at a season. Now, Prospero says circumstances allow him to take revenge on his enemies, and for this reason he has conjured the storm. Prospero charms Merinda and she falls asleep. He had summoned his spirit servant Ariel, who created the storm. Ariel says that he had made sure everyone made it to the island alive, but scattered separately. Then mentioned that Prospero promised to free him early in return for good service. Prospero angrily reminds the spirit that he saved him from the prison of the witch. Ariel apologized and followed Prospero's order. He made himself invisible and goes to spy on the shipwrecked courtyards. Prospero then awakened Merinda and summoned his servant Caliban, the son of witch. Caliban curses Prospero and denies that he owes Prospero anything for educating him. Meanwhile, Ariel, still invisible, lead Ferdinand, Alonso's son, to Prospero. Ferdinand and Merinda fall immediately in love, but Prospero put a spell on Ferdinand and takes him into custody. Elsewhere, Alonso, Gonzalo, Antonio and Sebastian awaken to find themselves safe on the shore. Alonso mourns, thinking that Ferdinand had drowned in storm. While Ferdinand does hard labor for Prospero, he encounters Merinda. They express their affection for each other. With secretly looking on, they agree to marry. A bit later, Antonio and Sebastian resume their plot against Alonso. But Ariel again disrupts it, appearing as a harpy. He accused them and Alonso of overthrowing Prospero and says that only sincere repentance can save them now. Alonso immediately repents. Antonio and Sebastian pledge to fight back, but Prospero soon enchant and trap them all. But at Prospero's cave, Prospero gave his blessing to Merinda and Ferdinand's marriage. In the play final scene, Prospero with Ariel's counsel decides that rather than taking revenge, he will instead give up his magic and forgive their enemies. He presents himself to them in the robes he wore as Duke of Milan. The courtyards are astounded. Alonso apologizes and relinquishes control of Milan, though Antonio remains silent. Alonso and Ferdinand are reunited, and Alonso gives his blessing to the marriage of Merinda and Ferdinand. Prospero then charges Ariel to ensure a safe voyage back to Italy for all, and then grant Ariel his freedom. The play ended and Prospero set Ariel free. This was all the ending of the happy ending of the play The Tempest. I hope you have understood, my dear students. Now we move next to the painted ceiling. Nice picture. You can see the ceiling. What the ceiling is having? Fruits, multiple fruits. Okay, this painted ceiling is written by Amy Lowell. She was born in 1874 and died in 1925. Was an American poet. She wrote imagist poetry and won Pulitzer Prize for poetry in 1926 after her death. Her most famous poetry was A Dome of Many Colored Glass, which appeared in 1912. The poem Painted Ceiling appears in the same collection. Okay, now I'll give a little introduction about this poem. The Painted Ceiling, written by Amy Lowell. The Painted Ceiling is much like a fable of the fox and the grapes. You must have heard this fable, no? The fox and the grapes. So it is just like that only, similar to that one. There is a fruit that can't be reached, but in Lovell's case, it is magical fruits. A painted ceiling is an ceiling covered with an artistic mural on painting. In the end of the Lovell's poem, she gives up on reaching the fruits because she is too short and resigns herself like a fox to being without it. Now, I would like to give a little highlights of the poem which will help you. Surely going to help you. The Painted Ceiling is a poem written by Emmy Lovell. She is revealing the poem as a little girl who is boasting about her grandfather's house. She says that that house have many attractive doors and windows, classy stairs going up and down, and a beautiful slippery floor. Then she says, out of all the rooms, mother's room, book room, her own room, her parlor, the hall, she likes only the green dining room because of its ceiling and wall. Right above her head in the dining room, fruits like apples, pears, grapes, melon, cherry and pineapple are tempting her. They all are on the ceiling and seems to tumble, but they never come down. She still keeps her mouth open, wide open in hope. At the end of the poem, she feels that she will die without accomplishing her deeds, as she cannot lift ladders or chairs because they are very heavy. She understood that those fruits are magical ones and she is too small and short in height to have them. Isn't it a simple poem? Here I have completed the highlights of the poem. Now, my dear students, these two lessons are going to come in mock test. You have to revise them thoroughly. You will not leave anything. You have to read the lesson, read the poem, write spelling you have to write, word meaning you have to understand. Then you have to learn question answers, reference to context, everything. You need to do completely. This is all going to come in your exam. I say all the very best for the mock test. Goodbye. Good luck.